Hello and welcome. Thank you for spending your time with me today to enjoy art and nature.
Hello and welcome to number 7, grapes. Now these grapes are Concord grapes. And I grew up with a grape arbor of Concord grapes in my family property. My grandfather was from Greece and he planted some Concord grapes and I love the smell. Greg is going to tell you a lot about grapes coming up, but look at those little clusters of beautiful. I'm going to eat one because they're... And some grapes have seeds. And look at the shape of that leaf. So a grape grows on a vine. Different than a tree, different than a shrub. A grape grows on a vine. And this is a little tiny branch. And the coolest thing about vines is, you know what vines do? They circle. And I've got this one little spot here that I'm gonna see if we can come in and show you. Oh, here's some more. They twist and turn and grip and pull and land themselves, and they grow and grow and grow like little tendrils, like curly hair, clutching onto whatever they can reach. So grapes come in purple and green and red. And have you seen grapes before? Have you tasted grapes? And do you drink grape juice? Or do you have grape jelly? And grapes, okay, for those of us that are over 21, wine is from grapes. Pretty good deal, huh? Pretty good plant, pretty good fruit. And grapes are a fruit. Here's a little cluster of grapes. So we're gonna paint grapes. We're gonna start out drawing. Look at that magnificent color. What's so beautiful is when I turn the grapes, the light catches, and I'm looking at a little cluster of grapes. And they go from purple to pink to light green right there. Look at that. And there's some little babies. Isn't that fantastic? If I really look close, there are a lot of different colors of grapes in here. And this one just is begging for me to eat it. So let's get out our pencil and our paper and we're gonna draw a cluster of grapes. And grapes are lots of little circles, right? Okay. So I've got my cluster of grapes, and let's see if I can count. You want to count with me? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 30 little grapes right there. So we don't have to make 30 little circles. But let's see how many circles we can make. And just to remind you, a circle, little orbs. Okay, so I've got my grapes, I've got my cluster, and I'm gonna start with a stick coming in. And then I'm gonna do lots of little circles. Whoops. Did you do a lot of little circles? And I'll come back and do it with my marker so you can see it. Here's my stem. Oh, and here comes a little friendly bug coming to say hello. And before we go to Greg to tell us about grapes, let's look at this and see how many colors you see. Do you see the dark, dark, almost black purple? And then a little winier color, a little red here. And then in here we see a red and a red to a green, and the babies look very light and green. All right, we'll see you after Greg. Have a good visit with knowing a little bit more about grapes.
Well, thank you, Judy. What a beautiful image of a grape that is. I wish I could draw and paint like that, but I'll just have to grow grapes. Today, we're going to look at some grapes growing in the garden. This is an old variety of grape that comes from Persia, which is where the countries of Iran and Iraq are. And these grapes are dark in color and seedless. They're called manuk. They're really tasty. These are Concord grapes. They're the ones grown in New York and Massachusetts. You've probably had grape jelly. These are the grapes used in grape jelly and probably your grape juice too. Nice and sweet, really tasty. They're named after the town in Massachusetts, Concord. These are some nice Thompson seedless grapes. They're white, they're really flavorful. In the old times, they were called sultanas, but today they're called Thompson, after Mr. Thompson, who developed this variety for Americans. Grapes grow on a special type of plant called a vine. A vine is a long branch that's thin and flexible, and so they will stretch the vine on a wire or a fence or even on a roof overhang structure called a trellis. You want to keep the fruit off the ground. That's why we grow them on wires and on trellises. Grapes are really important economically. They're grown in practically every country in the world, and most of the grapes are used for wine and our grape juice. It's a great way to preserve grapes because after you pick them, they don't last too long before they rot. So people will mash them and make juice, and they'll mash them and let the juice sit in a jar and ferment into wine. Or if you live in a sunny region, you can make raisins. And a raisin is a dried grape. So these white grapes are turned into golden raisins. Very flavorful. A raisin is a grape without water. So all the flavors and the sugars are squished up into this beautiful little package, which is great for eating or putting in apple pies or cookies. Just wonderful. You could do a lot with them. You can even pickle them if you wanted to. The leaves on grapes are beautiful. And they come in different shapes. Some have very distinct lobes, like right here. Others are more round, kind of like a dinner plate, like this one. You don't really see a distinct lobe. These are dentated, which means they have little teeth. Really pretty. This one comes from the wild Thompson grape. This is our Concord grape. They can also be used for cooking. So that's about all I have to say about grapes today. I hope to see you next time. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Greg, and what a cool plant. So here's the drawing. I'm going to put a little more paint on my palette, and we're going to paint lots of grapes, and I also think I want to paint the leaf in the grape too. I'm going to start with blue right now, and I'm just going to paint a few circles. Remember, we were doing circles, and they're small little circles. I'll make them big so you can see them. See those nice little circles? And do you know what two colors make green? Very good. Yellow and blue. Blue and yellow make green. The primary colors are red, yellow, and blue. And if I add a little red to the blue, I'm gonna get a purple just like that nice dark blue of those grapes. So let's talk about the leaf for a minute. The shape of the leaf, and many grapes have many different leaves. I'll pick up a little tiny one right here. Look at the shape of that leaf. Sort of like a heart with a couple of edges. Remember how Greg showed us about the leaf? So we're gonna do a little bit of a triangle. And for the Canadians among us, your flag a little bit, the maple leaf. Little similar to the maple leaf. I love red and green together. And do you know what red and green together make? Brown. Now I've got lots of white in here, but we'll come to brown for the branch. But isn't that a pretty color? Oh, I love color. I love color. You having fun painting grapes? Do you like grapes? And do you eat red grapes or purple grapes or yellow grapes? Do you ever have grapes that have a seed in them? Sometimes you can swallow the seed and sometimes you want to spit out the seed. See how I started the branch with a blue, and then I'm going to come back and I'm going to make it into a brown. So what color do you think I might want to add to it to make it to a brown? Very good. Let's start with a yellow, and I'm going to get some green out of that yellow. Isn't that cool? Isn't that a pretty green, and look at how if I add more yellow, I get a lighter green, and oh, I get to go back to the leaf. And then if I add a little of the magenta to this green, do you remember me saying that red and green make a brown? Let's see if we can make a brown out of that. And don't those grapes, aren't they starting to look delicious? Oh, so sweet. And painting, sometimes the paint takes on a life of its own and leads us into interesting directions where it's like, oh, pink, oh, I love pink. And oh, the background's pink, there's light coming from back there, huh? And the leaf is getting yellower and changing just like seasons and just like a plant growing, keeps going somewhere else. And all I did was make some little circles and keep following them, huh? I just keep following those little circles around and keep attending to them, going, oh, what would happen if I put a little magenta over there? Oh, what happens if I put a little blue? Look at that, isn't that nice? don't eat your grapes, even though they look good. They're a painting, but they look good enough to eat. Now my grapes look a little pinker than the grapes that I have in front of me, but that's okay. And there we are. There are some grapes for us. Have a very good day. Thank you.